Principal Dr. Kumar, all the faculty members, teachers, my dear students and their proud parents, members of the media. I'm extremely happy to be here amongst you today. This could have happened 2 years ago, as Dr. Kumar told, but at that time we had some other engagement. Nevertheless, nothing is too late, and it's a wonderful day, a colorful day for the institute and all the members of the family here. I'm grateful to the management for the honor and your young friend Vijay for introducing me. I just want to bring to your attention, there is a book that was released by ISRO 1 year ago that talks about from fishing hamlet to the red planet. That is the story of India's space program and why it's a fishing hamlet. We started the program in a very humble way in a fishing village in Tiruvananthapuram called Kumar. And that's the place where India's rockets get their launch. SLV-3, ASLV, PSLV, GSLV, LVM-3, whatever you talk about. They have launched not only our satellites, but several of satellites of other countries of the world. Nearly 20 countries in the world have made use of the rockets made by India. Very close to this institute is the Pina Industrial Estate. In the year 1972, the Aryabhatta satellite program was started here, and you met Professor U.R. Rao, who started that program. And 2 years ago, we had the historic event taking place here, where the Mangalyaan or the Mars orbiter mission finally became a success. First Asian country to do it. First time it became a success. That is the journey to the red planet. A program that started in the fishing village is finally contributing to a country's fishermen, farmers, decision makers, and virtually it touches the life of every Indian. If one satellite gets into a difficulty in the orbit, we all can feel that impact of it either in our communication system, in the ATMs, in the TV that we see, or in any services that are provided by them. Many people ask, what is the specialty of Indian space program? The very fact that we had started a program in the 1960s was not for technological one-upmanship in this world, but to make use of that technology for the benefit of our own country, our own society, our own people. And in that area, India stands first in the world, a role model for the entire world. This is one place where the frontier technology, which as I said started from the fishing hamlet, is used on a daily basis by the fishermen, farmers and other people. It has made a difference. We hear about cyclones taking place in the east coast of India. Every year it happens. This year also it happens. Somewhere in the 70s, we had more than 10,000 people dying due to a cyclone. But today, we are hardly a couple of people dying because of the cyclone happens. But what happens today is that information is available using the satellites well in advance, so that the people who are going to be in the affected areas can be relocated. And we have the ability, the science and technology in the country has the ability today to predict exactly where that is going to hit, which you would have seen. So thousands of lives saved is another major impact that we have gained. And if you talk about what is spent for this, it is a small amount. If you look at a country like America, NASA spends $19 billion in a year for the space program, whereas in India it spent $1 billion. And the benefits of all this reach people. Another most important thing which I wanted to convey to you, all this are done by men and women who have come out of institutions like what we have, including me. These are all homegrown people coming from various parts of this country who unite as a team and do an activity what everybody considers impossible. So how do we make that impossible to a possibility in science and technology in our own life? This is something which we can learn from this. And if you look at the guests whom you have invited, you can see there is no limitation in us. The limitation is we. If we can get out of that, if we can think, if we can dream high, if we can work together as we and achieve with grit and determination. If you don't get discouraged by failures, if you can learn from failures, if you can learn again from success how to do better, then there is no limit to our achievement, and that's what history says. And I'm sure all of you present here, especially the younger generation people, you should strive to keep a legacy behind when you leave this world after several decades of your life. Make a difference because of your presence, and it is possible, feasible. Thank you once again for inviting me and talking.
Sudana Sagodara Mumagana Magana ಮಗನ ಇಂದ್ರನ ಮಗನ ಅರ್ಜುನನ ತಳೋದರಿಯ ಸುಭದ್ರೆಯ ಮಾತುಳನ ಕಂಸನ ಮಾವನ ಜರಾಸಂಧನ ಅತುಳ ಭುಜವರರಿಗಾದಿ ಗಲಿದನ ಭೀಮನ ಅಣ್ಣನ ಧರ್ಮರಾಯನ ಅವ್ವೆಯ ಕುಂತಿಯ